Before Saren could land another blow, Mesvit pulled Ray away and thrashed at the party.
Mesvit!
Dark Elf stood protectively in front of Ray, growling.
He's guarding the elf! Strange!
Saren dropped his weapon and held his hands up, showing Mesvit he was no longer a threat.
I never wanted to harm Ray in the first place.
Oh, soft eye Ray.
Misfit's demonic features retracted just as Ray attempted to stand up behind him. They looked back at the forest elf.
You saved me. Why?
I've been on the other side of the dark.
Misfit looked back at Saren.
Show the lost the light.
I will, now that I understand what you were saying. I'm sorry.
Forest elves are not my enemy any longer.
You're right. It should be the other way around, too.
Misfit faced Ray completely now, and they took each other in. Brother elves for the first time. Like, this shit is rad!
Yeah.
Like, and to be fair, we have kind of earned it, right? Mm. Like, the reason why it's rad is because the game has, like, spent hours building up the fact that, like, even though we haven't had either of these guys in our party, they fucking hate each other.
Yeah.
Yeah. I also like the notion that, like, because of Misfit's demon blood, he just functions better down here.
Like, yeah,
he's like we're being tested and there's illusions. And he's like,
this is normal.
Sure. You don't get this all the time. You know, like, when you're above ground in the real world, you don't see
duplicates of yourself.
Yeah, you don't get this.
And, like, have, like, murder rages all the time.
Shit, what's that like?
God.
Right? Like, that's really interesting to me. Brother elves for the first time. That's a good line. The problem is to whoever designed this whole final sequence. Like, especially if our hypothesis is right and it doesn't actually affect our party for the end game.
Yeah. I'm a little uncertain because the choices do seem super arbitrary. Like, it's not...
Well, and that's why, like, if it affects the party, then it's kind of a problem.
Yeah.
But if it doesn't, then it's just like, okay, this is a free association thing.
Yeah.
Sort of live your best life and take character outcomes for it. But...
Well, and that's the other thing is, like, I'm having trouble guessing the character outcomes.
Yeah.
Oh, like, yeah, that's what definitely. If it's that thing, I'd want to know, I'd want to, like, some signal of what my outcome is being. So I'm going to be like, I care about...
Mm-hmm.
This character, I care about, like, this character, like,
I think that if it has no consequence,
or this story.
If it has no gameplay consequence, then I like that it's uncertain.
It's more that I don't know what story I'm telling when I make the choices.
Yeah, that's
it's
true.
Like, do you
that's
go
true.
Through door A or door B? Oh, well, through door A, you reinforce your relationship with Draco, and through door B... You confide your deep regrets and uncertainties in Apollo Michaud. But you don't know until you go through and they're completely... Anyway,
in the background of this shot, Karen is cracking Ray's crossbow over her knee, being like, nerd.
What are these tiny spears?
Look, mine's so much bigger.
We both have something to lose in this fight. Our lives, our homes.
Don't die.
Ray flipped his bangs out of his eyes.
Naturally.
They smiled at each other. Karen reminded them of their mission, and they left the chamber together. So we got both of them.
Sweet.
That's interesting. Is there a possibility to get both?
Pile of gold!
Golden gems litter the floor in the next room. What's up, Ramus? No one seemed to be around the treasure at first glance. Oh, Souser, really?
Oh, he was a thief!
Right!
Dude, it's not real.
Souser, are you okay?
Tja.
We know. We're trying to find everyone so we can get out.
Souser gazed at the gold pile. Without a word, he walked up to the treasure and picked up a few coins just to feel them.
Are you ready?
I'm not allowed to own possessions as a monk, you know.
Saren shook his head in belief, realizing that Souser was not okay as he first seemed.
My life before I became a disciple, all I ever wanted was gold and gems.
He clutched the gold coins tightly in his fist.
I became a monk to escape that life and repent for my sister. But have I? What has being a disciple of truth really done for me?
Souser, it's not about you. That's what
nothing,
repentance.
Dude. I haven't changed the world. I haven't repented for my sins.
You literally stood on a cliff fighting the undead for years.
They still happen. I'm still the same boy who wants nothing but this.
Threw the gold from his hands. It clanged loudly, making Saren cringe.
No, say he's changed the world. Yeah. It doesn't matter about him being a better person. It's that he is making a difference.
Mm-hmm.
You have changed the world. Without you and your monks, the undead would have overrun Mount Kronos. It would have been completely out of control, just like the demons are now. You're about to change the world in a significant way, too. Killing Faust will save all of Erevorn. You've completely earned all of my respect. Shaw.
Saucer turned away from the treasure, deep in thought. He laughed through his nose.
Dude. Thanks, dude.
Shaw.
Alright, let's go, dude.
I like that. I also like that the Souser is like super put together about the whole thing, right?
Yeah.
Like this is his jam. Like he spends his time punching undead and meditating on this very thing. What am I going to do in the afterlife when I finally reach it?
Mm-hmm. Will I find myself worthy?
Yeah. When Saren walked closer, however, there we are. A familiar dwarf jumped out from behind the sparkling piles. Well, shit! You killed Dora. Everyone gasped at how frightening Rammus had become. He was completely controlled by a phantom anger. No, to be fair, that's probably a legit anger.
Mm, yeah. Rammus put the axe down. First, didn't kill her. Second, not yours.
Yeah. Convince Rammus that Dora is alive?
Sure. No, Dora's alive. She's just not in this realm anymore.
Okay, I know how that sounds, but...
Yeah.
You let her die!
She was asking for help, so I helped her.
Gosh, you're a murderer. I'm saying.
No, it's not like that.
You're dead!
Ram!
Oof! Ram suddenly lurched at them with a crazed howl. Alright, so now we got some more peeps. So, I think we take Karin out of our front row and put Souser and Demon Boy in.
Yeah, see what Ray's like at this point in his life? When was the last time he was in our party?
When was the last time either of these guys were in our party?
Alright. Let's punch some people.
Alright, so Ray... headshot. Sure, sounds good.
Yeah, seems great. Oh, he's not confused. That's unfortunate.
Saren, just heal yourself. You have a heal that you can use. 80 hit points, not bad.
Sure.
That's most of them. Ken, what do you even do? You have a kick.
Can he buff himself?
Oh.
Oh, right. Dodgy.
Right, because his whole thing is he's got a chance to, like, counter.
Weak against cold and earth.
Yeah, weak meteor. Against earth.
Small one.
Yeah. One is in color. I wonder if it's... Has the game been showing us the best option this whole time?
No, I don't think so, but...
Kamara, he's also weak against dark magic.
Yeah.
We're still in level one. We could actually just stick him. We've got more
A lot of,
Misfit. We just want to hit him. Like, we got tons of people going.
Yeah.
Like, we don't need to spend the MP. Yeah. Oh no, he gets two shots if we...
Yeah.
What does the kick do? Oh, chance of paralyzing. Yeah, we can just keep chipping away.
This guy's doing no damage. Yay.
Reach 50 skill.
Oh, it's the first person to... Wait, what?
We didn't level anybody up.
Yeah, weird.
Rammus fell to one knee with a grunt. With grunt. Sorry, grunt.
It's the first time we've had somebody in our party with that much skill.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it is.
Plaintive cry?
Dora.
You'll be with her soon. Wait for us, please. Stay alive.
Before Saren could finish his plea, Rammus faded away, leaving the realm.
You're upset, nerd.
I hate this. I'm forced to put down my friends one by one like this.
You're probably,
how could Faust be so cruel?
You're so casual with your use of the word friends. You may have heard that it's not possible for jocks and nerds to be friends.
But there was a puppet show we used to put on in the slave pens. It was called The Breakfast Club. It was a show of hope and casual sexism.
I was going to say, did you read the Molly Ringwald wrote an article about her time in The Breakfast Club?
Yeah.
That was some heavy shit.
It is his nature. It cannot be helped.
It will be helped when he's back in Inferno.
Karen held her tongue as Saren stormed out of the cavern. Grass sprouted out of the cracks in the ground. He walked into a chamber that resembled the plains of Erevorn. Yeah.
Alright.
In the center of the room stood Amukiki, as if he'd been waiting for him. There were two swords stuck in the ground, like the duel with Cruel. You have finally come.
You were waiting?
Take your sword. Amukiki approached the sword closest to him. Saren could not mistake Amukiki's glare.
This is not mine. What's wrong? Why are you looking at me like that? Is this another sex thing?
I have sworn a new oath. Saren went rigid.
So it is a sex thing.
I have sworn not to let you pass.
Amukiki, did you side with Faust?
Have you done a bad? Take your sword.
He wishes to duel us. I'm not sure I could compete with him.
Demon elf boy. Get him.
You don't have to do this. Look into yourself. This isn't you.
I am thinking clearly. Amukiki pulled his sword out of the ground. His sword glowed just like the Wren's. Faust had deceived him with a false ancient blade. I have been promised many things.
Only a fool believes anything a Dyeth Knight tells them.
They're all lies.
No. Nomads will become true citizens of Erevorn. We will no longer be barbarians. We will be civilization. Faust will give us the world.
Oh, good grief.
Cruel was weak. He relied on an army. All I need to do is kill you. Take up your sword. I want to challenge his oath.
I want to save. I really don't want to not have Amukiki. Like, I think I'm starting more and more to think that we're gonna, when we finish and win, we'll see all of them back in the living world.
I hope not.
You swore an oath to Loren once, and now you've sworn an oath to her enemy. It can't be both ways.
Amukiki stood stoic for a long moment. Yes, it can.
No, two oaths.
You're right. My oaths conflict. He looked down at the false sword in his hand. I have failed. I must pay the price. He's gonna fucking commit suicide.
Oh dear.
Saren trembled, knowing only then what Amukiki was going to do. He looked away just in time before Amukiki took his own life.
Yeah, shall we beat the shit out of him instead?
I kinda just wanna keep going.
Alright. Alright, roll with the choices we've made.
Yeah. He deserved better.
Oh, sorry. We need to continue.
Saren took in a deep breath. It would be hard to shake what had just happened from his mind. The tunnel to the next cavern was extremely long, and all light disappeared. Saren had to feel his way through the dark until the tunnel expanded and poured out into a new room. A large field of light was stretched across the far wall. There were no more exits. He spotted a figure across the long room. Loren. He was elated to finally see her. So who haven't we encountered or collected? Trouble, obviously.
Trouble?
Is that it?
I think that might be it.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Saren was elated to finally see her. He turned back to see everyone else's reactions, but no one was there. Saren was alone.
Oh, shit. Another test.
Saren ran across the room to Loren, shouting her name. She didn't turn around to greet him. He got caught in the glow of the wall and slowed to a stop.
What is this? Is it a portal?
He looked over at Loren, but she was turning her face away from him.
Loren?
Even as Saren rounded to stand in front of her, Loren refused to acknowledge Saren.
Loren, why won't you look at me?
Loren turned her face away from Saren each time he tried to get her attention.
Oh.
This is awkward.
I am realizing that really what I want is your acknowledgement, and now I'm not getting it, and that's sort of a test.
If you're the real Saren, know that I'm not playing false game.
But I am the real Saren.
That's exactly what the fake Saren would say.
I just went through so many caverns and caves to find you.
Yes. All right. Fine. Trivia question. Jock or nerd?
Me, nerd.
It is the real you.
I had to fight with our friends and I brought them here, but where are they?
Saren started to panic. He had no proof of what he'd just been through.
Your mother was with me, too. Everybody.
Yes,
most,
yes.
Most of them.
And a scarecrow. What?
Queen Karen. She found me and told me about this being the Underrealm. We went through a series of tests and...
Karen looked past Saren and suddenly shoved him out of the way. Out of the tunnel, Karen walked into the light. She walked calmly forward, smiling when she saw Loren.
Oh, is she Secret Faust?
Almost certainly. But Loren drew her sword. This is the journey to the underworld portion of our hero's journey.
Yeah.
And your journey to the underworld requires a guide. Who are you?
Loren, that's your mother.
No. My mother is a jock, and that person is a nerd. She's not my mother. She's a nerd.
Daughter?
Saren recognized the exchange from when Karen had first met him in this realm. Was Faust imitating her? Saren backed up from Loren and toward Karen, putting him in the center of the room.
I don't know who to believe.
I have already met her.
Then you did not meet the real me.
That's exactly what the fake you would say. Loren spun around, turning her back on both Karen and Saren.
Dr. Loren, I think?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. What did you do with the other Karen?
I did what jocks do to nerds. I ignored her, as I should be doing with both of you.
Loren, don't ignore us. We need you.
And play into Faust's hands. I don't like being forced to play games for my enemies. Neither should you. And if you are actually real... Oh, if you are actually real... Loren scoffed and went silent.
We are real.
We are real.
How can I prove it to you?
Nerd. Loren was true to her word and did not reply. Saren slowly walked up to her.
Ask me a question, any question, something that only I would know and someone capable of duplicating our forms, voices, and attitudes wouldn't.
Loren stood silently, refusing to look at Saren, who was slowly losing confidence that he would convince Loren of anything. He was about to turn away in defeat when Loren opened her mouth. When we left the Citadel, you asked me a question. I called you a fool. Loren looked up at Saren. He stood at attention. What was it? So, I don't fucking remember.
No idea.
No fucking clue. Is the game gonna make us remember?
Yep.
Oh, shit! Oh, we asked why we weren't flying.
Yep.
100%. Why didn't we use the eagles? Loren stared at Saren without wavering. Saren held his breath, waiting for her response.
You think Faust wouldn't know that? Do you think he doesn't have eyes and ears across the whole world? What?
Karen sauntered over to Loren and Saren.
If he could infiltrate the Citadel to start a plague, then he has more ways of deceiving you.
I don't want to alarm you, Karen, but you are sounding more and more like a nerd? This is knowing things? This is not your...
Yeah. He could place spies right under your nose.
Saren felt Karen speak over his shoulder and he shivered. Loren started to look at Saren with suspicion.
Are you trying to say that I'm...
Karen shoved Saren toward Loren abruptly, making them both gasp. He looked down and saw Loren had grabbed the hilts of her swords.
Oh, you don't really believe her, do you?
Loren's harsh gaze did not lift.
Oh, you really... Oh, good grief. Go ahead, gut me, move on.
Saren was heartbroken. He'd served his mistress the best he could. He needed that loyalty repaid now, and it was not happening.
I'll prove it to you.
Saren pulled out his blade and took several steps back. Loren started to grow fearful. What are you doing?
I'm proving that I am true.
Saren prepared to kill himself. Just before he pierced his body, Loren knocked the blade from his hands. Stop, this is why I wanted to ignore you. Idiot. She cast a seething look at her mother. Her mind games are over now. Saren looked back at Karen, shocked. He hadn't realized for one moment that she was completely off this entire time.
Like, weird.
Yeah, sure. Karen got a hold of the Ember Blade with a grunt. It glowed extremely bright, turning on the whole room almost blue. Karen hissed and stepped backwards as if the light hurt her.
Oh, it's true. You're not Karen at all.
Karen lowered her arms from her eyes and readjusted to the presence of the sword.
You tried to resist the call of the Underrealm, but it still claimed the souls of some of your allies.
Fuck. Foss used Karen's image to laugh at Loren and Saren. They were disgusted to see Karen used in such a way.
And the Princess of Loren, she worked in my favor by shunning her own mother.
Where is she?
With your other mortal companions, in my control.
If we have to fight the other party, we're in super trubs.
Yeah.
Our party is good, but it ain't Mirth and oh, if we have to fight the other party and it's led by Karen, she's our secret weapon. Because her stats are so bad. That was enough for Loren. She sprang forward and impaled Floss' clone on the ancient sword. The laughter stopped abruptly. The fake Karen bent over the sword, threatening Loren with her eyes.
Your end is nigh.
She dissolved into nothingness. Loren gaped at the empty space for a while longer. Saren rushed to her and put a hand on her back.
Are you all right?
You're touching me.
That is just an image of your mother? Not really her.
I didn't kill her.
Loren!
They both jumped from hearing Karen's voice so soon. Out of the shadows of the tunnel came another Karen, distraught as if she'd been running a long distance. They all stared at each other for a second. When Karen saw Loren, she bounded forward. Instinctively, Loren retreated in case this was Faust again.
I thought I'd killed you.
Karen's eyes were fresh with tears as she finally caught up to her daughter. She grabbed Loren tenderly and brought her lips down to kiss her forehead.
Oh, darling, my darling, this is exactly how I behave.
Queen Karen, is that really you?
A quiet nerd.
Right.
Loren raised shaking hands to touch Karen's arms, the temptation to trust her growing stronger. She could remember vividly all the times she'd felt her mother's warmth. She held memories of an embrace at childhood where she won her first proving, a soft touch on the cheek the day she came of age, and the look in her mother's eyes when she saved her from the Chizulu ruins.
That's all of the times that
this
she was
literally
nice.
All of them. Loren knew that this was her mother. The feeling of her love was something she couldn't forget, not after it was so rarely given. Mother. Karen felt Loren grip her in return, squeezing her tightly. She had thought she'd lost her daughter even before the war, but she realized she never had.
Mel, relax now. Your dark witch has arrived.
Saren looked back at the tunnel. Kamara walked into the light behind Karen.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
And here they are! I told you that we did not lose them!
Mostly everyone. I was so worried.
Mostly. Saren pulled away from her mother, wiping her eyes. She resumed her stern demeanor, knowing that Foss was still at large.
What is this room?
They all looked at a large portal against the far wall. It rumbled mysteriously.
Ooh.
They were mesmerized while watching it pulse.
Unbelievable!
He walked up to the wall and waved his hand through the aura of light radiating from it.
This is no ordinary wall.
No shit, nerd!
What is it?
Nerd! Apollo Michaud struck his staff against the wall and the end of it disappeared. Everyone held their breath when he pulled the staff back out. His staff was cut clean off.
Everyone stand back!
Not my wizarding staff! No one had to be told twice. Anyone remotely near the portal jumped backwards.
I cannot believe where I stand. This is the mouth of death.
What?
We stand but paces from a permanent end.
I'm really confused.
We're dead.
No, it's the mouth of death.
Which side of that mouth are we on?
Not yet, anyway. We're literally on death's doorstep, though. Knock quietly. All we have to do is go in. And then we are dead.
So we're in sort of a limbo between life and death.
Voss should be on the other side of this portal, and it's because he isn't that's how he gets into our realm.
We're exactly where we need to be. This is where everything comes together. Voss will cross something something.
Into the realm, etc., etc. Alright, we need to get him in there. Got it. Headlock, nerd, through the portal. Done.
Princess, do not forget it will not be so simple.
Voss will not be the first nerd I've trounced. Thank you. Laughter. They all knew in fear it echoed around them. I forgot what he looked like! Oh my god! This time there was a body to match the voice. An animated suit of armor materialized in the center of the room. Faust. Crikey, I control everything. I control all of these realms. You're here only because I wanted you to be here. Many have walked your path just now, and all who die must pass by the gatekeepers of the Underrealm. I'm a death knight. You've been prepared for your death.
But I saved everyone I could from corruption.
Ah, ignorant mortal. Your choices in this realm determine if you spend eternity in torture and bliss.
Inferno and Elysium.
You'll spend eternity here. Powerful force shot from Faust and knocked everyone backwards. Saren's feet never left the ground, but he still pushed back. Faust's power level was too strong. Foster Lager blasted them all back a second time. They were closing in toward their doom.
You don't... What? You don't have to do this. We could be friends. We know that you are mortal, like us once.
Boss stopped his next attack.
The dark magic of this realm has corrupted you and turned you into a monster.
Boss's eyes flashed and he was eerily silent. Huh. You know nothing of me, mortal. You know nothing of the world that cast me out. Oh, it's getting bigger. The cavern rumbled as Foss grew double in size. He's literally getting bigger. You're in my world now, and I'll cast you out. Foss stomped on the ground, sending another powerful shockwave. Loren grabbed Saren as he came dangerously close to the portal.
I hardly think anything is evil, but for you, Foss, they're making exception. There.
Talk it up. You won't get another chance.
Enough. Loren heard her sword call to her. She knew it was time to use it. She gripped the hilt of the Ember Blade. Many things that were once unknown to her became known. She found impulses to perform attacks she had never performed before. The sword was guiding her hand. With the gods on her side... What if there's no final boss fight? What if this is shit? She just fucking headlocks him and dumps him through the portal. Just DDTs him. With the gods on her side, she knew how this fight was to happen. She knew that she was going to win. Nope.
Yep. She did. The rest of us totally bummed.
So Trouble just came along for the ride.
Nice. Great.
But yeah, it looks like we're shit out of luck for everybody else.
Yeah.
So we don't have a main tank. That's a problem.
And we're real low on all our mana.
Yeah. Especially our healer. So that's also a problem.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think... Like, maybe Trouble's a better tank than Mesfit. Because Mesfitz, he does a lot of damage, but he's so fragile.
Yeah, yeah, let's trouble it up.
Like, just trouble's got a ton of hit points.
Alright, yeah.
Yeah, this is the best we got.
Yeah. Alright.
Part of me's like, maybe Souser could dodge tank?
Well, also, if it goes poorly, we can find out.
Let's save our game.
Yeah. Alright.
Yeah, we don't. Oh no, hitting the restart button doesn't let it.
Oh, that's.
Oh, damn! He's that's a multi-part awesome. Enemy. All right, so resistant to dark magic. The center is resistant to everything. The body is weak to most elements.
Weak to fire.
And the arms are both resistant to dark. Okay. Ray, the first thing I'm going to need you to do is just pump my man here full of a potion.
Yeah.
He's gonna need some juice.
Yep. All right. Trouble? What does trouble do?
What do you even do? Increase your attack and speed for 30%. That seems pretty legit.
Yeah, that seems like a great opening. Breathe fire?
Yeah, just breathe fire.
And
and menacing growl. Pushes the enemy front row to the back row. I don't think we can push.
I suspect we can't push the armor around.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's speed him up. That seems like.
All right. So Saren's got some juice now.
All right, but he doesn't need it.
If anything, what?
That's what he needs to do.
He needs to juice up. Kambara.
Ooh!
Oh, that was 400 damage that he just took, and he is both staggered and confused.
Okay. Rally?
Yeah.
And now we...
Now we
lay down some...
Alright, so this thing is weak to fire, air, earth, and water. So, earth damage seems pretty decent. Do we wanna... No, this is net more damage.
Because it does next to nothing
that
to the
head's
head.
Only got like 400 hit points though.
Yeah.
Right? Like I feel like we can if we can get to it, we can just hammer through it.
Alright, well. Maybe we'll get trouble to try to push it. Try that pushback?
Yeah, it can't hurt, right?
Yeah. And Kambara.
Kambara. Dark magic is the obvious no-no, but she's got water.
Yeah, that seems to be fine.
Yeah, she can only affect a row anyway, so. Alright. Right, yeah, trouble. Let's get you to try this pushback.
Oh, he's staggered. He can't use his cool powers. Oh,
okay, well then, it was just.
Oh,
he's
that's
so
garbage.
Little damage. But honestly, if he can just soak damage,
yeah,
that'll be fine. And he's rallied and has an attack boost, and he does 22 damage.
Should we get him to punch a glove?
Yeah, like, probably.
Yeah, he does more damage to the glove anyway.
All right.
Ray, similar? Do we want him to punch that?
Ray can try and, like, 59, 35, 40. Like, he can start putting shots into the back.
Causing confused?
The head's immune to everything.
Alright.
But it's 70 damage. And the delay's only 6.
I'm just thinking of knocking down a gauntlet so we've got one less attack coming in. Unless he resummons his gauntlets.
Yeah, that's the other thing I'm worried about, right?
Okay, so, yeah, that's... Ooh, boy.
It just healed itself.
Okay, well.
In that case, yeah, let's start knocking down these gauntlets.
And we can confuse a gauntlet, so there's a chance. Yay, that gauntlet's confused.
All right.
Whoa, well, Trouble's down.
Yeah, well, that was Trouble's job.
Yeah. Oh, we could have done...
Ray, can you...
Oh, Frostbomb on the bottom left.
Oh, right, it's staggered now.
Yeah.
Ice Flask, yeah. That's a guaranteed kill is what
yep,
that is.
Yeah, there we go. Gauntlet down. Let's hope that stays down.
Yeah, all right. So let's get that water up.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. We don't have a choice here.
This may
show. Yeah, because Saren, I don't even care about trouble at this point.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, he can soak damage.
Yeah, but we have to put hit points back into that bank, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Seems good. Or we can put 50 damage on the helmet. Like the difference in damage.
Oh yeah, it's not that big on the front row, is it?
Yeah, no.
Alright, yeah.
Alright, so Saren, who do we heal? Just heal himself?
Yeah, keep himself up. And he only needs like a level 2. Yeah, that'll fill him up all the way up.
Alright, kill the other gauntlet.
And that.
Ray, keep putting fire on that helmet. Keep it up. Actually, no, put a shot into the gauntlet. Oh, wow, it's so low.
Yeah, because he's got so much. Yeah, that thing's got so much armor. Wizard staff, maybe the back?
Well,
oh no.
So if Kambara can land a solid hit on that,
oh,
Loren can just put it down.
Yeah, it is not resistant to.
No,
water. Yes. Keep her doing that. Yep.
Uh-huh.
Yep. 100%.
And then Loren just puts it down.
Yay!
What?
Oh, okay. Well, let's. He can bring them back to life.
Yeah, and he starts resummoning them. That's pretty decent.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
That gives Ray a shot at just killing that back one.
Yeah.
He
can also shoot the back one.
I think we need to throw a heal on Loren.
Okay.
Like even just a little one.
Yeah.
She is our main. Yeah. There we go. That's a kill shot.
Yeah. And
Kambara, what do you got? I'm gonna click this button.
There we go.
Please make this the final boss fight. Oh, it does not. We haven't fought his final form.
We have not fought his final form.
Fuck. Let's dial that back a little bit.
Dial that back.
This may hurt a little. Foss shrank down to his original size, falling backward against the portal to the realm of death. That was not even hard.
I mean, we do have the problem. Like, if you got the wrong party, that could have been horrible.
That's true. That could have been horrible. Well, finally, I thought they would never go down.
Is this all that we have to do? Is it over?
Oh, yeah. Great. Final form.
Or self-sacrificing tackle.
Hmm. The wall sputtered and reacted to Foss' body, but he didn't fall through. He wasn't dead. The gateway hasn't opened for him. Paul Michaud took a deep breath.
It's time!
Out of all the people we brought...
It's time!
Who out of all the people we brought with us is the most disposable right now? And everyone's like, why would you ask that? And you just kick Ray through the portal.
So, it's come to this. Dude.
Souser?
I couldn't explain how he got there, but with an increasingly bright aura around him, they knew there was a bigger question looming. The light started to look as if it was suffocating Souser. He looked like he was in pain and trying to fight off the aura. He's not just light. He's real dark magic. Souser fell on the ground, but he struggled to stand. Oh my god, that's right. Souser's got a fucking terrifying demon inside him, and has since the beginning of the game.
Does he?
Yeah.
I forgot.
Kambara noticed one time and was like, oh, how do you do that?
Help him.
No, it's too late for him.
That was an abrupt musical shift.
Oh, dear.
For a few agonizing moments, Souser was no longer fighting the dark magic.
Souser?
He stood up. Everyone knew that something was different and wrong. Oh my god, he's a Kuma. He's Dark Ryu.
What happened? Are you alright?
He was silent for a moment longer, frightening them all.
Souser?
Dude, is that still my name anymore?
What happened?
What happened to you? If you become a demon,
in the presence of the door to death, what I absorbed from Zeal must have gotten out of control.
A reminder of the Death Knight sent them all on edge. It was clear now what had happened, but no one wanted to say it.
He was right. I didn't banish him. I've become him.
No.
Yeah, because he swallowed the Death Knight that we fought.
Right.
Cesar looked at himself briefly and then his surroundings.
Dude, this is my new home.
Souser, no.
It's probably not bad being a Death Knight. I'm sure it has its perks. Actually.
Cesar walked up to Foss's waiting corpse.
Since I have the ability to get this guy gone for good.
Is that true? Are you certain? Seems a bit anticlimactic, really.
Yes. Listen, nerds. This jock is going to get it done. Look at him.
Curran was not the only one eager to hear this news. Loren and Saren looked hopefully at each other as well.
No harm in trying, dudes.
Propped up Faust and took a step back. After a moment of silence, he swung around and kicked the armor straight into the portal. Well, no more Death Knights, except for that one. Slipped effortlessly through the gateway and disappeared for what they hoped was forever.
He's gone? The great Lord Foss has crossed over. That should not have been possible.
I can't believe all this has happened. But I do know you saved one of our lives.
You bought the DLC, so you get to keep all three of your characters.
Oh, yeah, alright, yeah.
Souser stared at the portal. He lowered his eyes after a while.
What happens to you now? Do we have to kill you too?
If you want to.
Everyone was quiet.
Have your morals been compromised? Are you a changed man?
Don't feel as though I've lost my moral compass.
Can we trust a Death Knight? Even though he's our ally.
Death Knights become mad for millennia in the depths of the Underrealm. This is the young monk's first day.
Racist grandpa is right. Right? Like,
yeah.
Like, right now, he's like, no, dude, I'm totally in possession of my faculties. And fucking 1,000 years from now, he just roars out from under that volcano being like,
my dudes! Weep before my totally rad armies!
Like, that's sort of the problem.
Yeah. I believe we can and we should.
Oh, thanks, dude. Suppose I should tell you. Something that's been held secret in the Disciples since our creation. Only the Masters of Truth are allowed to know what I'm about to tell you. But if it'll help you decide. Our goddess Irijo was no goddess. She was a Death Knight. And she imparted her knowledge to us about the Underrealm, its creatures. Her once husband called her back to our world, but he was also the one to send her back as she asked.
What does that mean?
No, like, literally, what does any of that mean? We haven't talked about this for, I don't know, a fucking month.
Death Knights, dude. They're not all bad.
Loren thought back to how she was so determined to kill Zeal, even though he'd offered to help them.
There's still much we don't know. I don't want to replace Irijo. But I also don't think I have a choice about what happens to me now, dude. Please don't tell the Disciples. You can only know when they're ready.
We'll respect your secret, but can you send us back to our realm to keep good on this vow?
Totally.
Souser began to sign a gesture, but he stopped.
It's the last time we meet. Thanks for all the fun, dudes.
It won't be the last time.
Seriously, we're going to have to kill you. It's going to be really awkward. Souser smiled and continued his gesture. The cavern grew hazy, and they each found their eyelids getting too heavy to keep open. So I have questions.
Mm-hmm.
So Souser is a character in the vanilla game. We know that. And he's not a party member in the vanilla game. We know that, too.
So what happens?
Ooh.
How do you get home?
Maybe you just do.
Yeah,
right?
Maybe you just all wake up. Like, somebody kills... Like, somebody goes through that portal... With,
Sight of the Underrealm faded from their view. Saren could feel his limbs again. He could see, too. The dreamlike haze had completely left him. Also, we blew the fucking side off the volcano.
Hells yeah.
He picked himself up off the ground, and ash fell from him. The volcano that had once housed Foss's lair had been destroyed. All around him, his comrades rose from the rubble and helped each other stand.
Hooray!
Draco was crying for Saren, not finding him anywhere. Saren called to him. Draco stopped and reveled in the sight of Saren alive and well. The fire mage ran right up to Saren, who welcomed him with a longing kiss. Beko's tears began to dry as Saren held him close and showed him he loved him over and over. Loren and Karen were standing by the edge of the new cliffside, looking down below. It is a new cliffside! We blew a hole in the volcano! The armies below were celebrating a great victory and tending to the wounded. They had truly won the day. Saren took several very sore steps to stand by his majesties. They received him with a smile that said a million words. Loren started laughing at first, then Saren and Karen followed both.
Wow! Wow! Loren is creepy when she's happy. That is not...
She's like, looks down at the arrayed armies and the fucking desolated landscape and is just like, oh, hello.
Supreme Commander, don't you know?
Chosen by destiny. Their limbs ached, their wounds were deep, but they laughed until tears formed in their eyes. Cry! It was over. It was finally over, and no one had to say goodbye. They looked over the horizon together. Rescue teams began to scale the volcano's cliff. The sun was the same as the one they'd seen the morning they marched from Hammer Time. But at that moment, it looked brand new. Loren was crowned Queen of the Amazons. She was welcomed warmly by her people. Celebrations were held for months after the crowning, toasting to Loren and Karen's great triumphs. Loren made sure to use the knowledge the Great Mothers had bestowed upon her in her trial. But her rule would be different from tradition. It would be for the better. It doesn't say...
Ooh. First act was to make him a free man. Okay,
Second act, abolish slavery?
Yeah.
The transition was not as great as Saren was expecting, as he had been given much more freedom than he realized, but... The feel of first stepping out the Citadel's gates would be a memory he would long remember. That's how memories work. The most important... Yes! She did! She abolished slavery!
Yay!
Holy shit! We got there!
She learned things!
The most important decree of Loren's rule was the immediate release of all slaves from the service of the Citadel. All sons born of Amazon women were given full rights and citizenship. Not everyone was as pleased with the new direction of the Amazons, and some rebelled against Loren. However, they learned that she was not a weak queen. She handled all of her challenges with ease, earning her their newfound respect. Sure. But more importantly, abolished slavery and fought for it.
Yeah.
Between Saren, Loren, and her defenders, the discrimination against men slowly faded away as they proved to be a beneficial part of their society.
As they had literally always been, but now also, like... equal citizens.
Yeah.
Like,
you cannot you cannot be granted rights. You can only be denied them. The concept of a male Amazon became more of a reality as their civilization grew. Karen became a representative of the Amazons to the Empire and the Elves. She helped change the world's view of the Amazons, just as Loren was changing things within the Citadel. It seems like a really good job.
Yeah.
She found ways to build trust with the lizard people in the swamps, because Karen likes that lizard D.
No, remember we had that thing where she was, like, imprisoned by the lizards, but later we went back and saw, like, a lizard woman protecting her, like...
Yeah, that's right.
And we were like, maybe she was like, just kill all these
she
people.
She was like, actually, also like... they own belts.
Yeah.
Like,
if, like, oh wait, this is a civilization.
Like, if belts aren't a mark of civilization, I don't know what is, right? Like, the ability to forge metal, the ability to tool leather, and the notion that you need to keep your fucking pants up... Right? Like, she built trust with lizard people in the swamps and helped show Erevorn they were an intelligent and unique race worthy of respect. Misfit took his father's place as the leader of the desert dark elves. He could never return to the forest like his brothers, but it was comfort enough for him to know that it was now an option available to his people. The call inside of him would never truly go away, but he learned how to overcome it. Mirth became a renowned elder druid like she already was, calming radical isolationists with swords and magic, and showing the beauty of opening the forest up to the world. Though some elves still insisted they didn't want to be influenced by any outside culture, most elves saw that they could keep their culture while embracing others. The Empire made efforts to repair the rift between the human and elven nations after pressure on the council from Apollo Michaud, who was reinstated as a council's official racist grandpa by popular demand.
I like made efforts. Yeah. Like they didn't. There was success, but they tried. They did. They tried to try.
There was great support from both populations, easing the passing of a decree that formally made the two nations allies. I get that it's happy endings all around,
mm-hmm.
and I like that. What I really like though is each of these endings, like these little like paragraphs. Is a thing that reflects deeply on what has happened in this game. Like, the person who wrote these thought very hard about what a happy ending looks like for each of these individuals, right? It's, like, patient and thoughtful. And it's not just like, yeah, and then they all went home. Yay!
Yeah.
Like, this is like, we have changed the geopolitical landscape of this world, and here are ways in which it has changed. It's very Mass Effect.
Mm.
Apollo Michaud himself was finally able to pursue his alchemy in ways that could help the whole world.
It's very Dragon Age.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Like, it is super Dragon Age
Again,
Inquisition.
Again, I maintain that, like...
You've never hit the end of Dragon Age Inquisition.
I have not.
This is Dragon Age Inquisition.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
Like, even the palette.
Like, I maintain that this is a game that is best compared to Dragon Age. Like, it's like, low-budget Dragon Age. And I don't even mean that as a slam.
Yeah, but, like, that is...
But like the mechanics and the plot are essentially the same.
Yeah.
Apollo Michaud himself was finally able to pursue his alchemy in ways that could help the whole world and not just himself. He took on as many apprentices as he could handle, one, and helped spread his knowledge of the science across Erevorn. Many lives would be saved from his discoveries. Right, because he made that miracle cure.
Yeah.
Dora returned to her grimy grimoire and took full advantage of her new celebrity.
Didn't she used to wear a shirt?
Yes. I don't know what's going on there. She quickly became one of the most accomplished relic hunters, learning to use her skills for good rather than greed. Rammus returned home to Hammer Time and took his brother's position as head of his family.
Oh good, they don't add up together.
Yeah, that is really good.
Yeah.
He even dabbled in politics, though his arguments were mostly him insulting his opponents. Amokiki worked to help reestablish the nomad tribes in the north. While some were moving back south to find their herds, many nomads wished to stay. And Mukiki helped spread tolerance and support for his people, and the nomads came to respect him instead of shun him. Kambara was finally allowed to move back to her home in the swamps, where she lived in solitude as she really preferred. Witch hunters would never cease to exist, but Kambara had earned herself a good enough name to live in relative safety for the rest of her life, which was quite long.
Mm.
Saren became the Amazon ambassador between the Citadel, the Empire, and the Forest. Which
isn't
is a
that what Karen
isn't that literally what she does? He liked that his job allowed him to travel often and meet routinely with old friends. His heroism inspired the Amazons and others to think more highly of men. With each generation, the gap between the factions closed tighter and tighter. Because of Saren's duties, he couldn't be around Draco as much as either of them wanted, so with mild persuasion, Draco convinced Saren to give up his job to someone else. They could find a life together. Also, notice we haven't talked about what Draco does.
Mm.
They purchased a bar in Hammer Time where Draco could perform magic as local entertainment. That sounds hazardous.
Yep.
Not only were the dwarves religious drinkers, but they had an innate appreciation for Draco's tricks, turning their business venture into a great success.
Weird.
Weird, but touching.
Yeah. Right? Like, it's fine?
Like in the sense that it's like, what do they do? They're great heroes and whatnot. And it's like, all we really want to do is, like, we just go somewhere and open a bar and just, like... be normal people for the rest of our lives.
Yeah.
Which is pretty sweet.
It is.
I dig it.
Saren is one of the greatest healers the world has ever known.
Yes.
Draco, one of the greatest sorcerers.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nice that they're running a pub together. Odd, though.
Well, I think part of the notion is, like, there aren't a lot of, like, Draco-caliber threats remaining.
Fair,
right?
Fair.
They fought armies of demons and the undead and hellhounds and all that. But it also sort of in my headcanon, it opens it up for that, like, put the band back together adventure, right?
Yeah.
Humans and elves from across the world traveled to their pub to watch Draco perform, turning him into the famous magician he'd always claimed to be. And Saren gave him that which he'd always wanted, love from a good friend.
Wait, what?
Cop
out on the last line of the game.
Cop out on the on the gay sex times, because... So I'm going to read that line again. Saren gave him what he'd always wanted, love and the D. Oh, was the last line of the fucking game?
Okay.
Oh no, here we are. The candle flickers its last breath of life, snuffing out the light in the room as it turns to liquid wax. Right, because this started as a storybook at beginning. Right. The monk continues to hold his quill above the page, now too dark to write more. He leans back in his chair, satisfied with the story he managed to write thus far. Even though there's more to tell, the story of Loren, Princess of the Amazons, has reached its end. The monk's withered hands reach up to cloak, or to reach up to his cloak and pull down the hood around his white locks of hair. He approaches the monastery's window. The tale of Loren had been written, and her people would read from these scrolls, learning how glorious a queen her great mothers must have welcomed.
Those are words.
Yeah. He feels the breeze on his face. Now we're in present tense, too.
Yeah.
A tense shift is really interesting. And an ancient ache in his heart. Those last words he had written had struck his core. But he smiles to himself. Not only Loren's story was told that night.
For you. So Saren...
Saren is the monk.
Saren is the monk.
Saren leaves the window because he's the greatest healer the world has ever known.
Yeah, fair, yeah.
And slips into his bed, prepared for the relief of a deep, deep sleep. Are more words? Is this... Okay, credits.
Yeah, no.
Awesome.
So yeah, basically the last line of that game was them copping out on those two actually having a romantic relationship.
Yeah, that's weird. All in all, though, this game was awful and I never want to repeat it, but it had a lot of really interesting moments.
Yeah.
And I it deserves credit for that. Like, there's a lot of really cool shit going on here, and it's shit that you would... Like, that you couldn't get at a Dragon Age.
Sorry. That person's role is screenwriting and hot scenes expert.
Yes. They're a lady.
Sorry, I interrupted you.
Yeah, no, but like I said, I think that the... Yeah, there's some neat stuff going on there, but... There's definitely, like, you can tell that there's, like, three or four different writers. And because there's, like, these dramatic fucking tone shifts. And it's really hard to, like... Either that or the same person writing it over a really long time.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, this game is so weird. I do not want to play another one of these, though.
No, I'm good. I'm glad that we did this.
Yeah.
I have enjoyed my time.
I'm shockingly happy with the ending. Like, I wasn't sure. I figured it would be one of those, like, Dragon Age-style endings, but... I didn't think about what that would include, and it included everything I wanted it to include, except for the gay bits.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, everybody sort of retired to do something interesting, but something interesting that makes sense for their character.
Yeah. Like, they are moving forward with their character's story.
Yeah. And you're like, oh, okay, like, this is a thing that logically moves forward from your, like, it moves your story ahead, it makes sense... It does something useful, like it isn't just like, oh, they retired into nothingness, except for Kambar, who all she wanted to do was go back to her swamp.
Yep.
You notice we didn't find out anything about the end of Souser.
Well, like you said, 1,000 years from now.
Yeah.
My dudes!
Oh, man. Oh, these games are a thing. Yeah, we are not going to play any more Winter Wolves games, probably.
I suspect not. Aww. I mean, unless somebody's like, they have gotten worlds better, you must play this.
Yeah, well, Steam recommended this to me.
Yeah.
Steam thought I would enjoy it.
They were right.
Yeah, more or less, yeah. There are definitely... Ooh, fucking after credit scene!
Ooh!
The Everburn Mountains were the quietest they'd ever been, but the smoke still billowed from the Black Volcano. Inside the remnants of Foss Slayer, the forgotten ashes of his armor looked like nothing more than dust. The ashes were playfully kicked by a lone succubus.
What happened to her?
Her and Grob, right? Like, we never fought Grob.
Yeah.
Who then stood dominant over the vanquished demon lord.
Gratuitous butt shot.
Of course. Jewel was free of his control and his bothersome rules. She'd helped return him to power, but she was never valued. Now, Everburn was hers.
I see one slip through the net.
One slip through the net, dude. Jewel spun around with a gasp. An ethereal monk crossed his arms and shook his head at her. You need to go home now.
Who are you? You're a...
I'm the new one, dude. Sazer started to approach her. Jewel covered her mouth and staggered backwards.
Do not kill me.
Give me one reason. Succubus took a deep breath and gave Sazer what he asked. Jewel did not die that day.
Is that a blowjob?
I'm pretty sure. You have unlocked cheat mode. When you start the game again, press the C key to access a cheat menu. Story mode will let you automatically win all battles, useful if you want to replay the game quickly to see an alternate ending. I respect that that mode exists.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still not replaying this game. But nope. I respect that that mode exists. That's it!
Hooray!
Loren, Amazon Princess, and the Castle of Namar. Yeah.
Yeah?
We're free.
Hooray! Oh boy.
That was such a good that was a really interesting ride. Like there was a lot of shit going on there.
Yep.
I'm excited to do Valhalla.
Yeah, because it is apparently good.
Well, not only is it good, it's much smaller.
Hmm.
Right? Like
Valhalla. Like it's gonna be like two or three nights, not
No, just in the, like yeah, it's not. Like, it's not in a both. Pub. Like it's not okay. Two. It's not two fucking novels worth of text, which is what we just read aloud.
Yeah.
By the way, I would point out that Pillars of Eternity is one novel.
Mm.
But
a lot more walking.
Yes. And the combat is harder.
True.
Let's.
That was a game to play on easy if you were streaming.
Where are we here? Where's my room cam? Is it this one? No. It's this one. There we go. Valhalla is smaller in scope. Like, there's no, like, world-saving things. Like, you're mostly just sort of learning about these people who come through. And, like, there's a lot less sort of moral posturing. Right? Like, it's a lot more ordinary and that kind of thing. Like, it's very different. So I'm intrigued for that.
Cool. I'm excited.
Yeah. It's good. I watched a Let's Play of it, I think, a couple years ago. But I didn't watch the whole thing, so I don't know what the ending is. Oh, man. It is 10:15. We're pretty good on time.
Yeah, no, we did all right.
Nice. All right.
All right. Thank you, White Wolves.
Winter Wolves.
Winter Wolves. White Wolf publishes LARP books. Winter Wolves makes visual novels. Got it.
We're going to go.
We're done.
Yeah. All right.
Yeast.
Later.